बादरायणम सूत्र भाष्य कृत वंदे भगवंत पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवत् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। श्री चित्तम सप्रकाश व्यापक नाम रूप अधिष्ठान बुद्धि बोध्य बुद्धि परम सर्वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्येक परम तदेवाहन्नमत्तो निरिति में निश्चिता मतिः। We have to look at the tippana. So pratyaksha jnanam is of two types, abhijna pratyaksham and pratyabhijna pratyaksham. So now the definition, simple definition is abhijna pratyaksham. As you saw, abhijna pratyaksha needs only indriya. So kevala indriya sannikarsha matra janyam is abhijna pratyaksha, whereas pratyabhijna pratyaksha needs purva anubhava janya samskara also, along with that indriya sannikarsha also. Thereby both are needed in pratyabhijna. Now looking at the nayayika's way of defining, there is some analysis done there. प्रत्यक्ष ज्ञान सामग्री सहित संस्कार जन्यम ज्ञानम प्रत्यभिज्ञा प्रत्यक्षम इति कथ्यते। सो इन द डेफिनेशन देयर शुड नॉट बी अतिव्याप्ति अव्याप्ति असंभव दीज काइंड ऑफ फ्लॉज। सो द डेफिनेशन इटसेल्फ इज लुक्ड इनटू, आई विल क्विकली गो थ्रू दिस एनीवे। एज लॉन्ग एज वी अंडरस्टैंड दैट प्रत्यभिज्ञा मीन्स दैट देयर आर टू फैक्टर्स एट प्ले, इट इज ऑल्सो प्रत्यक्ष दैट इज सफिशियंट, एज इन कंपेरिजन टू अभिज्ञा वेयर ओनली one factor is at play, only indriya, whereas in pratyabhijna, indriya and purva samskara both are there. Pratyaksha jnana samagri sahita samskara janyam jnana pratyaksha pratyabhijna pratyaksham iti kathyate. So what is pratyabhijna pratyaksham? It is that jnana which is samskara janya along with the pratyaksha jnana samagri. Both are there. Samskara is also there and pratyaksha jnana samagri is also there. Whatever is needed for pratyaksha jnana is needed. Along with that, samskaras are also additional. Samskara sahita indriya janyam jnanam pratyabhijna pratyaksham iti lakshanasya. Baihya pratyabhijna pratyakshe sambhave api antara pratyabhijna pratyakshe asya lakshanasya asambhavat avyapti syat. So in the definition, if you define the pratyabhijna, in a sense, that if the pratyabhijna definition were to be samskara sahita indriya janyam jnanam, as given there, samskara sahita indriya janyam, then what will happen? This is what in the mula it has been mentioned, samskara sahita indriya janyam jnana pratyabhijna pratyaksham. In that lakshana, in that definition, what will happen? Baihya pratyabhijna pratyakshe sambhave api, even if it applies to the pratyaksha outside, which kind of pratyaksha? Pratyabhijna. If you are looking, soyam gajaha, soyam devadatta, there this pratyabhijna will work because you have saha. Saha is samskara. Saha devadatta is a samskara. And then there is indriya janya jnana, which is ayam devadatta. So ayam devadatta, there saha devadatta. Anya desha, anya kala, varti devadatta is this devadatta, ayam devadatta. They are both same. Seen many years back in a different place, but still it is the same. There, Saha Devadatta is Sauskara Janya and Indriya Janya is Ayam Devadatta. Therefore, Sauskara Sahita Indriya Janya Janyam Jnanam Pratyabhijna Pratyaksham Iti Lakshanasya. In that definition, what will happen? Baihya Pratyabhijna Pratyakshe Sambhave. In Soyam Devadatta, Sahayam Gajaha, there this applies, even though it applies there, api antara pratyaksha vijna pratyakshe asya lakshanasya asambhavad avyapti syat. It will not apply to pratyabhijna within. I am the same person who woke up now, who was sleeping yesterday. There it won't work, and there in the antara pratyaksha it won't work. Antara pratyabhijna pratyaksha, the pratyabhijna which occurs within, there it wouldn't work because it is not indriya janya. When I say that I am the same person who slept yesterday and woke up today, the I that slept yesterday was not, there may be a samskara. Let's say there is a samskara of I yesterday, and the waking up me is not known through indriya. Therefore, indriya janya samskara sahita indriya janya jnanam, that lakshan of pratyabhijna will not apply to antara pratyaksha. Antara pratyabhijna pratyaksha. This is called as avyaptihi. Since it is not possible, it is not covering the inner pratyabhijna, it is covering only the outer pratyabhijna. Therefore, there is avyapti. Avyapti means the definition is not broad enough to cover all which should be covered. It is not applying to everything where there is pratyabhijna, but this definition is not covering the inner pratyabhijna. Tasmat prathamoktam eva ubhaya vidha pratyabhijna pratyaksha sadharanam nirdushtam lakshanam. So this lakshana, this definition which is sadharana, where it just talks about samskara and talks about indriya janya, those two factors together, that is insufficient. There is a avyapti doshaha. So therefore, tasmat prathamoktam eva ubhaya vidha pratyabhijna pratyaksha sadharanam nirdushtam lakshanam atrayam vishesha. So what was said earlier there, that works well. So what was the definition given there? Kevalam indriya sannikarsha janyam jnanam abhijna pratyaksham, and then purvanubhava janya samskarana indriya sannikarshena cha utpannam jnanam pratyabhijna pratyaksham. There he's explaining that atrayam vishesha. He's explaining what is the difficulty in that definition and what is right. Samskara janyam jnanam smriti ityukte pratyabhijna jnanasya api samskara janyatva tatra ativyapti syat. There is more issue with the definition. Samskara janyam jnanam smritihi. Smriti is defined as samskara janya jnana. In that definition, ityukte pratyabhijna jnanasya api samskara janyatvat. Then when you said samskara janya jnana is smriti, that samskara janya part, the dala, there are two parts to the definition of pratyabhijna. There samskara janyatvam is there. In smriti, you have not said kevala. You have just said samskara janya jnana is smriti. Therefore, that will have ativyapti even in the pratyabhijna definition, where there are two components, samskara janya and indriya janya. So samskara janya, pratyabhijna is also samskara janya, smriti is also samskara janya. Therefore, smriti definition being samskara janyam jnanam smritihi, this pratyabhijna being jnana, being samskara janya, this will also fall under the category of smriti. But it is not smriti. Pratyabhijna is not just smriti. Tatra ativyapti syat. So this definition covers what it should not cover. That is ativyapti. It is broad enough to, it is broad enough to cover the definitions intended, but it is transgressing into others where the definition does not fit. Tadvaranaya smriti lakshane matra padam niveshyam. So when you define smriti, what should be said? Kevala or matra, meaning samskara matra janyam jnanam smriti, that should be the definition. Ityukte samskara matra rupa samagryaha anubhava nashanantaram sada vidyamanatva sada smrityutpatti prasangaha. Now if you say samskara matra janyam jnanam smritihi, that smriti is that which is samskara matra janya, then what will happen? Samskara matra rupa samagryaha anubhava nashanantaram sada vidyamanatvat. In this definition also there is an issue. What is the issue? Samskara matra janyam jnanam smritihi. There what will happen is that this samskara is always there. Samskara matra rupa samagriya. Just the samskara is always there. You are born with samskara, that is the reason you are born. So samskara matra will always be there. Some samskara will be there. every now and then. Therefore, what will happen? Samskara matra rupa samagri is always available. Even after anubhava, this smriti anubhava, I'm recalling this right now. When do you say that I'm recalling this night right now? That kind of samskara will always be there as soon as you recollect. Not always be there. When do you make that statement? When you recollect something, some anubhava you recollect, then that time you make that statement that I recollect now. I gather it now. Or I remember now. That moment only the smriti should fit in. But anubhava nashanantaram sada samskara matra rupa samagriyaha vidyamanatvat. Always that samskara of that anubhava will always be there. Therefore, sada smrityutpatti prasanga. Always there will be smriti of that because the anubhava nasha has taken place, but still the smriti continues to be there. But you don't say that I remember all the time. How many things will you remember simultaneously? Because every anubhava will leave a smriti, will leave a samskara, and samskara matra will always be there. So samskara matra janya jnana is not smriti. Ataha tadvaranaya smriti lakshane udbhuta padam api niveshyam. So that jnana, which is not born out of samskara, but it is udbhuta, means at that point of time it should come up. So that jnana which is born in that kshana, that is smriti. So that should be added. Tathacha udbhuta samskara matra janyam jnanam smritihi iti nirdushtam smriti lakshanam. So this is a good lakshana. Just like the earlier lakshana here, prathamoktam eva ubhaya vidha pratyabhijna pratyaksha sadharanam nirdushtam lakshanam. This does not have dosha. So what was said earlier in the definition, there it should be what? The pratyaksha jnana samagri sahita samskara janyam jnanam. So it should not be samskara janya jnana. So I was searching above here. The first definition is given here. So I got a little lost when he said tasmat prathamokta. So prathamokta, I was searching in the mula. It is given here. So I'll go back and cover that also. So what is the nirdushta lakshana? In the earlier, there is avyaptihi in this definition. Samskara sahita indriya janya jnanam. And that is what is mentioned here as purva anubhava samskarena indriya sannikirshana cha utpannam. But purva anubhava is there. What is said here? Purva anubhava, obviously samskara is due to purva anubhava. In fact, I said that I'll cover less of this. But since there are questions on tarka and this is tarka pradhana, at least in the initial stage, we have to see the accuracy of tarka. What is the accuracy of tarka? When you define something, it should not be a loose definition. You cannot use a loose definition. Nobody knows what you are talking about. So you may be somewhere else, you may be meaning somewhere else, but the discussion is not possible. So when Bhagavan Bhashyakara also says something, he is assuming the lakshana. So when he uses the pada anubhava, people get confused. Anubhava is jnana because it has not been refuted. The lakshana of anubhava and jnana fits together. Smriti bhinna jnanam anubhava is the definition of nayayika. We have not redefined it. At least Bhagavan Bhashyakara has not redefined it. And I didn't find it elsewhere. Unless anubhava is defined in a particular manner, denying that the smriti bhinna jnanam anubhava as defined by nayayika, we accept that. So whenever we do not, we use sankhyas, nayayikas, purvamimamsakas, yoga, all that they have put together, we use all that. Except when they talk about siddhanta, which is opposed to Shruti, we say, we set that part right. It is not that we throw everything away. So tarka is also useful. Without tarka, you cannot do manana. And as and when more questions come up, they have to be logically settled down. They should be traced back to Shruti if you have enough Shraddha. If you do not have it, then tarka will be the entire life. Still, at least in some manner, it should be convincing. Therefore, tarka should be accurate. And for that accuracy, tarka shastra gives you. Nyaya shastra, nyaya vaisheshika shastra is twofold. One is their philosophy, the other is the analysis. The methodology of analysis is what we agree with. May not be completely in the sense that when it overlaps with their darshana, we don't agree. But otherwise, generally, even Bhagavan Bhashyakara will talk of pragabhava also. But in Siddhanta, we'll refute pragabhava. Loosely, when you say that, you know, I want to apply it to some kind of analysis which is laukika and in tarka and discussion, there we accept, okay, pragabhava, we accept. We do not accept bheda in abhava, but we accept that, okay, tarkikas, you considered this way, let me look, put on your shoes and discuss with you. So there we have to use their definitions as well. So in those definitions, they have to be refined so that there is no ativyapti, avyapti and asambhava dosha. So in the earlier, this lakshana samskara sahita indriya janya jnana, why is it not defined in that manner? Because there are only two things, samskara and indriya janyatvam. Only two things are there. And samskara is what? Obviously purva anubhava is there. But that purva anubhava should be of which kind? What should be this indriya? This all should fit in the definition properly. This definition should not have ativyapti, avyapti, asambhava dosha. So here what is happening? It is not covering the antara pratyabhijna. Therefore, pratyaksha jnana samagri sahita samskara janyam jnanam is a nirdushta lakshanam. It does not have this avyapti flaw. Because it is saying tasmat prathamoktam eva ubhayavida pratyabhijna pratyaksha sadharanam. Ubhayavida pratyaksha sadharanam nirdushtam lakshanam atra ayam vishesha. And then we looked at the smriti lakshana. Their smriti lakshana should not fall into the, it should not cover the pratyabhijna. Therefore, matra pada was added. If you add matra pada, then the other dosha will be there, that smriti will always be there after the anubhava ceases to be. Therefore, to take that away, another udbhuta pada should be added in the lakshana. So this is how the nayayika goes. They keep on adding each and every word. There should not be more words than necessary in a definition. The definition should be as short as possible and it should not have these other doshas. So to take away one dosha or the other in the definition, you add words, but those words should be only as many as sufficient to take away the three doshas. They should not be more. So anyway, that was the focus here to mention that how the definition goes in tarka. Okay, so sapne jayamanam gajadi jnanam na samskara matra janyam. We have seen that tarka drishti's question. Going back to Moola, what is the question? In the context, the question is sapna is not mithya. Therefore, jagrat is not mithya. Not other way around. Sapna is mithya, therefore jagrat is mithya is the siddhanta. Tarka drishti is saying jagrat padartha is satya, therefore sapna is satya. Why? Because it is smriti. It is smriti of jagrat padartha. That was denied first. And the other option, athava, what he had said is athava, what is it? Athava swapna jnana vishebhuta padartha satya eva na mithya. How? Swapnavasthayam stula shariram tyaktva linga shariram bhair nirgatya sarvam satyam giri samudradikam pashyati. Ataha swapna na mithya. So swapna is not mithya. For what reason? He said that the linga sharira travels. That is tarka drishti's perspective. So swapne jayamanam gajadi jnanam na samskara matra janyam apitu nidra rupa dosha janyam api. This swapna is not smriti of jagrat padartha. Then how is this gajadi jnana born in swapna? That is not samskara matra janyam. There is samskara factor, but there is also nidra rupa dosha. Apitu nidra rupa dosha janyam api. The nidra dosha is there, otherwise you cannot have swapna. And what is this nidra dosha? Nidra dosha is that where you are withdrawn from the jagrat avastha. When you have smriti in the jagrat avastha, that time you are not withdrawn from the jagrat avastha. You know very well that you are in a present deshakala. You are in the waking state and in the present deshakala, and then you recollect something. This is not the anubhava of the swapna darshana. During the swapna darshana, that itself is the deshakala. The world outside is current, it is not recollected. in that you can have a smriti. In swapna you can have a smriti where you recollect some other desha kala in that swapna desha kala. That is smriti. But jagrat smriti is not there in the swapna, whereby you say that this entire prapancha is recollected from the earlier waking state. That's not true. So swapne jayamanam gajadi jnanam na samskara matra janyam apitu nidra rupa dosha janyam api. And this is why Mandukya Upanishad explains that when you switch states, you necessarily go through nidra. Sushupti avastha is what you go through actually. You withdraw from the waking, jagrat avastha, go to sushupti, then you go to swapna avastha. From swapna you go to sushupti and then you come to jagrat avastha. The projected vikshepa of the prapancha should be withdrawn before another vikshepa takes place. This is different from smriti. In fact, you have forgotten the waking world and then you are having the swapna prapancha. You are forgetting the swapna prapancha and then you wake up. There you have smriti of, oh, I dreamt. But then in swapna, you don't have jagrat prapancha smriti. Gajadiriva swapne kalpita indriya kalpita indriya adikam api vartate. Why so? Why is swapna not only samskara matra janya? Nidra rupa dosha is there, one. Other thing is that it also has indriyas at play. You cannot have no indriyas at all. Kalpita indriyas are there. Let's say in jagrat avastha you have real indriyas. In dream, if you do not have indriyas, there cannot be any samparka with any vishaya which is seen outside. The dreamer does not see the world within. The dreamer sees the world outside of the dream body. Therefore, gajadiriva swapne kalpita indriyadikam api vartate. There is not only gaja outside in swapna, gajagiri ityadi. The entire swapna prapancha alone is not outside. There is also indriyas which connect with the outside prapancha. Both are kalpita, but they are still there. Be it kalpita, but are the indriyas there? Then indriya janmyattam will also be there. Therefore, what will happen? Tasmat swapne gajadi nam jnanam indriya janyam. The jnana of the swapna gaja will be swapna indriya janya. Yadyapi swapna padarthaha sakshibhasyaha na indriya janya jnana vishayaha. Even though it is Sakshi Bhasya, the Sakshi Chaitanya has Swapna, who is the witness to Sukha Dukkha in Jagrat Avastha. Similarly, he is witness to everything happening in Swapna. It is Sakshi Bhasya. It is revealed by the Sakshi, revealed to the Sakshi, revealed by the Sakshi. Still, Na Indriya Janya Jnana Vishaya, still Tathapi Aviveki drushtya swapna ajnanam indriya janyam iti kachyate. Still, it is not a siddhanta in the end. In the end, we will refute all that because everything will be finally sakshi, revealed to sakshi alone. But still, when you are comparing waking and dream, then indriyas are there. The dreamer does not know that he is dreaming, so indriyas are there. Therefore, aviveki drushtya swapna swapna jnanam indriya swapna. This should be swapna jnanam, not indriya ajnanam. This should be swapna jnanam. This akara is a typo. Swapna jnanam indriya janyam iti kachyate. Tathacha swapna padartha jnanam na jagrat padartha gochara smriti. So swapna padartha jnanam, the swapna padartha knowledge of the swapna padarthas is what jagrat padartha gochara smriti hi. Na, it is not the smriti of the waking state padarthas. Kincha nidrata prabuddha purusho vadati swapne adya gajamaham appashyam iti. Swapna gaja jnanam yadi smriti syat tada prabuddha swapne adya gajamaham asmarsham iti vadet. Natu kopi tatha vadati tasman na swapne jagrat padartha visheni smriti hi. Why is it not smriti? Because the dreamer, once he wakes up, he says that I saw an elephant in dream. He does not say that I recollected an elephant in dream. Nobody says that I recollected something in the dream. Everyone says that I saw something, I tasted something, I did something. It is not a smriti. Otherwise, how would a person waking up from dream talk? What would be the waker's expression of the swapna anubhava? It would be that I recollected this, I recollected that I did this, I recollected that I saw this. Nobody talks like that. Therefore, swapne jagrat padartha visheini smritihi. Swapne na tasmad na swapne jagrat padartha visheini smritihi. It is not a smriti because nobody talks about it as smriti. Everyone talks about it as anubhava only. अपि च जागृति दृष्टानाम अथवा श्रुतानाम पदार्थानाम एव ज्ञानम स्वप्ने जायते इति नास्ति नियमः. एंड दिस जनरल रूल दैट यू आर मेकिंग सेइंग दैट स्वप्न अनुभव इज ऑलवेज ऑफ ओनली जागृत पदार्थ दृष्ट पदार्थ जागृत अवस्था दृष्ट पदार्थ. इट इज नॉट जागृत अवस्था दृष्ट पदार्थ ऑल द टाइम. इवन वन एक्सेप्शन विल रिफ्यूट दैट. You may have anubhava that of swapna anubhava of something that you have never seen. There is no such rule. Apitu jagrati ajnata padarthanam vijnanam swapne bhavati. Unknown things in jagrat avastha are also known in swapna. That is how people have, you know, avishkara. They talk about something, you know, I don't know, I dreamt about this. Let me try it out. It worked. And then they say that this was unknown to me, now it has become known. Somehow something is revealed in swapna, seen in swapna. They apply it to waking and it works. Iha janmani kadapi adrishte ashrutasya cha vilakshanasya padarthasya jnanam api kadachit swapne bhavati anubhutascha ananubhutascha iti shrutehe. So there is a smriti which says in swapna what do you have? Anubhuta and ananubhuta also. You may not recollect it, but it is possible. Just by saying that it is possible, someone had it sometime also is enough. Therefore, the rule that you say that everything in swapna is a smriti or whatever I have had anubhava of in waking state, that alone I have experience of in swapna, that is incorrect. तस्मात् स्वप्ने जायमानं ज्ञानं न स्मृतिः. Therefore, swapna is not smriti of jagrat avastha. यद्यपि इह जन्मनि अनुभूत पदार्थ ज्ञानजन्य संस्कार एव स्मृति हेतुः इति नास्ति नियमः. जन्मांतरीय अनुभव जन्य संस्कारस्यापि स्मृति हेतुत्व दर्शनात्. Now this is obvious that okay, I did not see it in this janma, but in earlier janma in jagrat avastha I may have seen some padartha, heard some padartha, and in this janma I recollected that in dream. Why not so? Yes, possible. But how do you know that you had heard and seen or seen this padartha in jagrat avastha in the last janma? There is no pramana for that. It can be a swapna anubhava also earlier. It is going to be inconclusive. Shruti says anubhutascha ananubhutascha. If you have shraddha, then accept it that you cannot say that this was experienced in waking state only. This is the basis by which Bhagavan Gaudapadacharya says in the Karika, Mandukya Karika, that in the Hetu Phala Sambandha is the Bijankuranyaya that you are using for Karya Karana Sambandha, the Sharira and the earlier karma, all that is bogus. Bogus in the sense what? It is not real. You cannot say that there was real karma, therefore there is real Sharira born, there was real Karana, therefore from real Karana, real Karya is born. You cannot make such saying that it is Bijankuranyaya and thereby there is cyclical, there is a series, not cyclical, series of seeds and saplings. Similarly, there are series of hetu and phala. The word uses hetu and phala there. Hetu phala. Phala leads to hetu. Hetu leads to phala. So on. So you cannot say that I have karma due to which I am born again. The sharira is there. The sharira will be the cause for more karma, which will be the cause for more shariras, and so on. it will that endless series that you talk of, where you cannot talk about the first, and therefore you say this seed depends on the ankura. The seed depends on the tree, and the tree depends on the seed. That mutual dependency will make it cyclical. You take away the cycle by saying that it's an infinite series without anadi series. It has no beginning. Still, that adi cannot be questioned. Even if you accept it hypothetically, you cannot say that it is real. What is being refuted is reality to janma. So it is ajatavada. In ajatavada, if the argument is that like the tree, real tree is born from a real seed, this sharira, this prapancha is born from real karana. It is really born from real karana. That really born is being refuted by saying that this series that you talk about does not stand scrutiny at all. It is illogical. Because series is made of members, this member being real cannot be established. The karya being real cannot be established. The janma of the karya being real cannot be established. There is an apparent reality, just like it is in Swapna. And there is no niyama that the earlier should be real. So something which is not real, mithya, can also lead to mithya karya. So mithya karana can lead to mithya karya. This is how the argument goes there in Mandukya. So what is being said is that in earlier janma, what you have seen in Jagrat Avastha can be a karana for Swapna in this janma. But earlier janma Swapna Anubhava can also be the reason for the Swapna here in this janma. So it cannot be established. Tata hi pravruttim prati anukulata ishta sadhanata jnanam karanam tadabhavi pravruttya darshanat. So pravruttim prati anukulata jnanam karanam ishta sadhanata jnanam karanam. So for pravrutti, for any engagement, whatever jnana is facilitating that is karana. Tadabhavi pravruttya darshanat. If you do not have a jnana which helps pravritti engaging that, there won't be any engagement. That is why you know something and then you do. What you are doing, at least you know what you are doing. No, I don't know, I am doing something. That is, you don't know exactly what you are doing, but at least you know that I am, you know, putting my hands together, I am using this particular tool. That much jnana you have. So pravrittim prati. And that is the case in Swapna also. Tatahi pravrittim prati anukulata jnanam karanam tadabhaya pravrittya darshana tatascha jatamatrasya shishoh stanyapane prathamika pravrittye karanabhutam sanyapanam mama ishta sadhanam iti jnanam bhavati. There should be ishta sadhanata. That is why he said anukulata is ishta sadhanata. I like something there. It is ishta. The product is, whatever is the resultant of some pravritti, some engagement, some karya, that is wanted by me. For whatever reasons, whether I like it or dislike it, there should be. Sadhanata is ishta. I may not have a desire to do that karma at all, but still I engage in that because something, the means there is going to give me that result. And the idea is to get the result. Therefore, some samskara should be there. And what is said here is pravrittim prati ishta sadhanata jnanam karanam. This also is there. Ishta sadhanata is there. In Swapna also it will be there. In any pravritti of Swapna also you will have ishta sadhanata. Just like in waking you have it. And how is this earlier janma samskara karana now? If that is also questioned, that is explained here. Tatascha jatamatrasya shishoho. A child who is just born, you know, newborn. Sanyapane prathamika pravrutte karanabhutam stanyapanam mamishta sadhanam iti jnanam bhavati. How does the newborn know how to suckle the mother's breast for milk. One can say that the mother brings the child close to the milk and then the child suckles on the mother's breast. Is that true? The child suckles on its own. How does it know that I'll get milk, and how does it know that it will satiate my hunger? That newly born child cannot have that jnana, which is taught in this janma, but it does have jnana that stanyapane prathamika pravruttehe shishoho jatamatrasya shishoho karanabhutam stanyapanam mama ishtasadhanam. Drinking the mother's milk is going to satiate my hunger. That jnana has to be there, which is from the earlier janma. Tatra cha janmantare shishoho stanyapanasya anukulata anubhuta. There is anubhava stanyapana of earlier janma. That becomes the karana for that's the samskara which comes up in this janma also. Thereby tadrusha anubhava sahita samskara vashad asmin janmani shisho prathamiki stanyapanasya anukulata smritir jata iti vaktavyam. Therefore you have to say that even in this janma even if the shishu jata matra shishu does not know, still you have to say it knows from the earlier janma. Otherwise, there will be no first pravritti in stanyapana. Tasma janmantariya anubhava janya samskara adapi smritir bhavati. So you cannot say that jagrat avastha in this janma alone has led to my swapna in this janma. It can be the earlier janma samskara. Can be waking or dream. We don't know. Earlier janma samskara. How it came, I don't know. What is it? What was the exact anubhava? I don't know. I don't know my earlier janma at all. Tasma janmantari anubhava janya samskara adapi smritir bhavati evam eva iha janmani ananubhuta padartha visheka smritirapi janmantari anubhava janya samskara vashat swapne sambhavatyeva. So you cannot say jagrat avastha smriti is there in swapna. That's what swapna is. It can be janmantariya smriti also. Tathapi jagrati yasya padarthasya jnanam kasmin api janmani kadapi na sambhavet tadrusha padarthasya pratiti swapne bhavati. And what is the other possibility as well? More possibilities are there in swapna. Swapna cannot be said as idam itham. Only this manner the swapna can be. If you knew what the swapna is, then you won't pray. You know, there are people who pray, you know, let me not have nightmares, especially those who have nightmares in childhood. If you look at them, the state is, you know, it's very scary for them. Even as grown-ups, people who have nightmares, they have whether a child or a grown-up, a nightmare will scare the person. So the people pray, you know, and in fact there are prayers as to some swapnas are, you know, they considered evil omens. So people pray. In Jagrat Avastha, they go and pray in the temple to their Ishta Devatas, Gurus, and say that this is what I saw in Swapna. What should I do? What is the Parihara? Why? Because there is something in the Swapna which is unseen, unheard, something comes about, and then the person had no knowledge that such will be the Swapna. Somehow it has come about, and now one is scared. There is no reason to be scared because it is mithya, but still I don't want to go to sleep. I am scared to go to sleep because I don't want that kind of swapna. I cannot say whether what kind of swapna I'll get. This is the case of such people who go through nightmares. So tathapi jagrati yasya padarthasya jnanam kasmin api janmani kadapi na sambhavet. Impossible that I have seen it in some janma, even that kind of padartha. Tadrusha padarthasya pratiti swapne bhavati yatha kadachit kaschana swapne samastakam chinnam anyatra patitam swachakshusha pashyati tatra na kopi jagrati chinnam swashiro anyatra patita swachakshusha drishtavan. How do you say that impossible? It can be that in some janma I have seen this. No, you will not have seen this. That is the kind of example that someone gives, that the sadhu gives. Let's say there is a dream. Is there a possibility of a dream Dream can be anything. So assume that somebody had a dream that, what is that? The head, one's head has been cut off and it is lying on the ground, and one sees that. Very scary. Dream is that the head has fallen off elsewhere and one is noticing that. Can that be your anubhava? Is the question. There is no anubhava of seeing one's own head fallen on the ground. Of course, people make arguments that one may have seen somebody else's head fallen on the ground. You are not alive to see your own head on the ground. The dreamer is not alive if the head, I mean, the anubhava, if it is from Jagrat Avastha, from any other janma, still in that janma, there cannot be an anubhava of the head being cut and fallen on the ground. Someone else may see, but that person will not see his own head fallen on the ground. But that can be a dream. Now, somebody can argue that, okay, you have seen somebody's head fallen on the ground and you are recollecting that it is your own head. How can you recollect that it is your own head? You can recollect that it is someone's head. You will not have the anubhava of it is my head which has fallen off. That smriti can't be there. So you cannot call it as Jagrat Avastha Smriti, you cannot call it Janmantariya Smriti also. Swapna can have ananubhuta. Therefore, anubhutascha, ananubhutascha. Padartha jnana is there in Swapna. Tasma Jagrata Padartha Anubhava Janya Samskara Vashat Swapne Smritir Bhavati Iti Kathanam Atyantam Asangatam. Therefore, this is completely invalid to say that Swapna is Jagrat Samskara alone. It is Smriti. That is not right. Swapnasya smriti rupatva khandane anantayuktayaha granthakarehi tatra tatra uktaha. So many have talked about this in various granthas. To do khandana of swapna smriti rupatva. Swapna is smriti. That is negated in many granthas using logic. And that is what is summed up here as well by many granthakaras. Tatracha smriti jnanasya visheyuna kvachidapi sammukhe vidyamanataya pratiyate swapna gajadayastu swapna kale sammukhe vartamanataya pratiyante tasmat swapne gajadi jnanam na smritihi. So the sangraha vakyas where brief refutation was done earlier, that is expanded here, and thereby what does the sadhu say? Swapna gajadayastu. In comparison, tatracha smriti jnanasya visheyuna kvachidapi sammukhe vidyamanataya pratiyate. When you recollect something, when it is a memory, then you don't say that I see it in front of me. You say I recollect what I saw in front of me, I recollect now. But in swapna what happens? Swapna gaja is not a recollection. It is seen right in front of you, the dreamer. Swapna gajadestu swapna kale sammukhe vartamanataya pratiyante. They appear as though they are right in front of you. Tasmat swapne gajadi jnanam na smritihi. Therefore, the swapna padartha is not smriti. Iti idam purvoktam dushanam prabalam. So as it was briefly mentioned earlier, it was elaborated, and this is the smriti of Jagrat Avastha is swapna is invalid. Is negated in many, with many examples and with many logical points. Swapne linga shariram stula shariraat bahirgatva satyagiri samudradikam na pashyati. And what was said, athava, the second option that Tarkadrishti gave is that the sukshma sharira travels when the stula sharira is lying in the bed, and then there is anubhava of the same padarthas which are real. And this is discussed in Mandukya Upanishad. This point is discussed in Mandukya Upanishad. But there are more details given here. In the Karika and Bhashya. Swapne linga shariram stula shariraat bahirgatva satyagiri samudradikam pashyati iti yaduktam tatra uttaram uchyate. If you say that the sukshma sharira travels during the dream and goes to various places really which are real, therefore swapna anubhava is real. Like Jagrat Anubhava is real, Jagrat Prapancha is real, Swapna Prapancha is real. What is the answer there? Yadi stula sharirad bahirgatva linga shariram satyam giri samudradikam pashyati tada linga sharirasya bahirgamanat maranavasthayam yatha stula shariram bhayankaram bhavati tatha swapnavasthayam api linga sharirabhavat stula shariram amangalam kunapa sadrishan cha bhavet. Kunapa is a dead body, which is amangala also. You know, culturally, if you touch a dead body, you have to have a bath. It is ashuddha, amangala. It is inauspicious. Generally, you know, don't go to look at dead bodies. In fact, in the Bauddhas, for Vairagya, they do meditation on the dead bodies. Anyway, that's an aside. It is Vairagya Karaka. It is amangala. Bhayankara. It will cause fear also. That's why people want to do away with the dead body as soon as possible. If at all the linga sharira, sukshma sharira separates from the stula sharira and travels outside, then what will happen? Which is the case, you know, where stula sharira is separate from the linga sharira. The sukshma sharira leaves on death. That is what travels from one stula sharira to another stula sharira, which is what is called as the jiva has got another janma. Has got swargagati. You are praying for that sukshma sharira sahita atma, praying for the gati of that atma which is along with the sukshma sharira, who has separated along with the sukshma sharira, he has separated from the stula sharira. That is marana. So just like in marana avastha, let's say it is not marana, but it has temporarily separated. If it has separated, then stula sharira will become bhayankara. It cannot survive without sukshma sharira. It will start to rot as well. So it should become like dead body. But you see that it is not like dead body. Prana is going on. The prana continues to be there. The stula sharira is there. Nobody thinks that the person is dead when somebody is dreaming. Natu tatha swapnavasthayam stula shariram bhavati kintu swapnavasthayam api stula shariram prana sahitam jagrati eva sundarancha bhavati. It is as beautiful as in waking during dream also, that sharira. Tasmat stula shariram vihaya swapnavasthayam linga shariram na bahirgachati. So sukshma sharira separates from the stula sharira during dream is an invalid proposition. Atha yadyuchyate. So if the argument there is swapnavasthayam prana na bahirgachanti kintu antakkaranam indriyani cha bahirgatva parvatadikam pashyati. If one says that, no, I meant sukshma sharira goes out, but pranas you will still see in the sharira, prana, because prana is continuing, sukshma sharira is gone. Hey, how does the sukshma sharira travel outside without prana? One of the pranas, pancha pranas, helps the sukshma sharira throw itself out of the stula sharira. Udana vayu. That udana prana which helps, meaning prana which helps, the prana cannot continue in this stula sharira and say that sukshma sharira is gone. Sukshma sharira is taken outside the stula sharira by the prana. Prana cannot be at both places. Prana is either in the stula sharira where the sukshma sharira is, or it will be the sukshma sharira which is traveling to other lokas, hanging around waiting for another sharira, preta sharira. Still, the argument that prana is continuing in the stula sharira in swapnavastha, whereas the linga sharira, sukshma sharira is traveling, is not possible. Travel of the sukshma sharira itself is not possible if prana is not accompanying. Now, this kind of analysis is not done elsewhere, but it is needed to do dvaita khandana, where people think that swapna is real. And this is the bread and butter of drishti srishti vada, which is for an uttamadhikari. So the analysis starts with uttamadhikari analysis itself in detail. Then it goes to some other analysis. The more the questions, in the uttamadhikari's prakriya itself, if there are more questions, then the adhikari is madhyama. If there are still more questions pending, then he becomes adhamadhikari. Still he is an adhikari. So all questions have to be answered. If the person thinks that swapna is real, you cannot say, no, what kind of nonsense is this? Get lost. Cannot do that. It has to be answered. Why is it unreal? So in Tarka, logically one may say, oh, what if it is possible? Because thinking is that prana is me. As soon as prana goes, the life is gone. So that is used as a tool to take away misunderstandings. If prana is gone, the body won't survive. And you are saying prana is there, therefore body is surviving. But sukshma sharira is traveling. How will it travel? Prana makes the muscles move. Sukshma sharira also needs to move. To move, it needs prana. So that is the accuracy of analysis. In manana, all this is needed. If the granularity of the analysis is as much as the granularity of the question. So no question is invalid. Therefore, this detail is also needed for whoever the questions come up. Therefore, prana cannot go out. If one says that pranas do not go out, but antakkarana goes out, antakkarana cannot go out without prana. Prananam bahirgamana bhavad eva maranavasthayam eva stula sharina na bhayankar bhavati apicha swapne prananam bahirgamane na kinchidapi prayojanam asti yatah prananam jnana shaktir nasti. Swapne prananam bahirgamane na kinchidapi prayojanam asti. So the argument is that in swapna prana has no role. Prana has no jnana shakti, so prana need not come along to objectify the real giri parvata, giri samudra ityadi. So sukshma sharira can do on its own. Prana has no jnana shakti, so prana traveling outside has no prayojana. Yatah prana nam jnana shaktir nasti, kintu kriya shakti revasti. Prana has kriya shakti all right, but has no jnana shakti. So what is its prayojana in traveling outside? This is the pura paksha. So there is no need to travel. It remains in the stula sharira. Sukshma sharira has jnana shakti, it travels. Tasmat bahya padartha jnana samarthyam yesham asti tanyeva bahir gacchanti. Those who can cognize, indriyas can cognize the bahya prapancha. So indriyas travel. Prana does not have the capacity, prana does not travel. Jnana shakti cha antakkarana jnana indriyanam cha asti, prana nam karma indriyanam cha jnana shakti nasti. So jnana shakti is there only in the jnana indriyas. They travel outside during swapna. Whereas prana and karmendriyas do not have jnana shakti, they have kriya shakti, they stay within the stula sharira. Kintu kriya shakti revasti tasmat swapna avasthayam prana karmendriyani cha stula sharire eva tishtanti atascha marana nimittaka dahadi bhyaha stula shariram saurakshitam bhavati. Therefore the prana protects the stula sharira from being burnt, etc., from all the other issues. As soon as you know somebody thinks that the body is dead and then takes it away, the body, stula sharira, will be woken up by prana. This is the idea there, as to the Purvapakshi saying that the sukshma sharira travels, but prana remains in the stula sharira during swapnavastha. Swapnavasthayam antakkaranam jnanendriyani cha bahirgatva satyagiri samudradikam drushtva punah prananam karmendriyanam cha samipam pratyagacchanti. So during the swapna, the sukshma sharira bereft of prana travels, cognizes the dream, and then what is that dream? That is the real prapancha outside. Then it comes back and joins the prana and the stula sharira. Idam na sangachate. This is not valid. Why? Stula sukshma sangata madhye prana eva swami. In the stula sharira and the sukshma sharira, prana is the make or break. He is the master. Everyone follows prana. That is why when prana leaves, sukshma sharira cannot stay back in the stula sharira. When prana goes, the stula sharira is dead, sukshma sharira has to be forced out. Prana heena deham kshanardham api gehena stapayanti bahiraranyam nitva dahanti. So that stula sharira, when prana goes away, does not survive at all. It starts to rot. It has to be burned. Nothing will survive when prana is not there. So people take it to cremation ground and burn it. Prana rahitam shariram sprushtva snanti cha. And having touched the stula sharira, which is bereft of prana, people have to take a bath because it is ashaucha. Atas stula sharirasya sarah prana. What is the sara of stula sharira prana? What is the sara of sukshma sharira prana? Tata sukshma sharirasya vipradhana prana eva. Tatahi prana indriyani cha sveshu kas shreshta iti vishaye parasparam vivadam apannaha prajapati samipam gataha तम अपृच्छन् को न श्रेष्ठः इति. सो देयर इज अ स्टोरी गिवन इन द उपनिषद्स एज टू एवरी इंद्रियास, यू नो, ऑल ऑफ देम वेंट टू प्रजापति एंड आस्क्ड हू अमंग अस इज श्रेष्ठ. दे वर फाइटिंग. सो इन द स्टोरी इट इज सेड दैट प्राणा इज श्रेष्ठ बिकॉज विदाउट प्राणा नो वन विल सर्वाइव. सो दैट विदाउट हूम others cannot survive is shrestha. Who is that? If the eyes go, then one still survives. Every other indriya survives. If the eyesight is lost, prana also survives. Each and every indriya being lost, others do survive, prana survives. But prana going away, nobody survives, none of the indriyas survive. सहोवाच प्रजापति. व्हाट डिड प्रजापति आंसर? यस्मिन् वौत्क्रान्ते स्थूलमिदं शरीरम अमंगलं भवति सवश्रेष्ठः. सो अमंग यू व्हेन हूएवर लीव्स द शरीर आई बिकम्स अमंगला. इफ प्राणा गोज शरीर इज अमंगला. इफ चक्षुरिंद्रिया गोज श्रोत्रेंद्रिया गोज नोबडी थिंक्स दैट शरीर इज अमंगला. देयरफोर अमंग यू दैट particular entity shrestha iti prajapatir vachanam shrutva krameṇa ekekam indriyam sharīrāt nirgatya samvatsaram bahir ushitvā punah sharīram pravishan. So each indriya left in the analysis, in the story it is said that each indriya left for a year and came back, but still everyone had survived except for prāṇa. As soon as prāṇa left, the sharīra along with indriyas went for a toss. Tada tattad indriya pravasa kale tattad indriya prayukta darshanadi roopa vyapara vikalam api idam shariram anda badhiradi roopam bhutva praneena avashtabdam sadvidrutam atishtat. So only that particular indriya did not function in the body when that indriya left for a year. Indriya devata, indriya devata left, that is the idea there. So finally body still survived, the other indriya still survived when other than prana anything left the body and other indriyas. But prane tu uchikramishati vikalam idam shariram bhumau pipatisham pipatishati sma. But what happened? Sma will convert this latlakara to past tense. So what is said is prane tu uchikramishati vikalam idam shariram bhumau pipatishati sma. But when the prana went, then what happened is that the sharira dropped on the ground. Tada sarvani indriyani prana eva nashrestha iti nischikyuhu. Then all indriyas agreed that prana is shrestha. It is ascertained. They are convinced. There is no doubt at all. Tasmad yavad deva asmin dehe prano nivasati tavad deva itara indriyani tatra tishtanti prane tu utkrante itara indriyanyapi tad anutkramanti. Tasmad sukshva sangatasya raja iva prana eva pradhanaha prane shariraad anirgate antakkaranam jnanendriyani cha na bahirgacheyu. Therefore prana is pradhana. Without prana there can be no travel also. The sharira cannot survive, sukshma sharira also cannot survive, no indriyas can survive. Therefore your argument that prana remains and the indriyas travel during swapnavastha is invalid, that is not possible. We'll look at the tippana and अत्र प्राण शब्देन इंद्रिय शब्देन च तत्तद अभिमानी देवता ग्राह्यः. बिकॉज दी इंद्रियाज आर जड़ा, देवताज इंद्रिय देवताज अधिष्ठात्र देवताज आर बीइंग टॉक्ड अबाउट इन दी कथा. इन दी कथा दैट इज व्हाट इज टॉक्ड अबाउट. विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम दी अथवा इन दी नेक्स्ट पाठ. सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपं अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्येतुं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम महः तदेव अन्नमत्तो निश्चितामतिः. नमस्ते. एनी क्वेश्चंस? डू यू हैव क्वेश्चन चैलेंज मां
हां नो
सर यू वांट सी क्वेश्चन मां
नो नो नो
यस नो ओके नो क्वेश्चन आई सॉ यू अनम्यूटेड आई थॉट यू वर सेइंग समथिंग ओके नमस्ते
थैंक यू नमस्ते
हेलो